हेलो, वेलकम टू वीकेंड इन्वेस्टिंग डेली बाइट्स। इट्स जून 18th, वी आर ऑन एपिसोड 34। लेट्स लुक एट व्हाट हैपेंड इन द मार्केट्स टुडे। सो द मार्केट्स वर वेरी वेरी वॉलेटाइल टुडे। देम ओपन्ड अप, बट देन निफ्टी हैड ए अबाउट अ 300 पॉइंट ड्रॉप, एंड देन बाय द एंड ऑफ इट इट ऑलमोस्ट रिकवर्ड एंटायरली। निफ्टी वर्चुअली ओपन क्लोज फ्लैट। स्मॉल कैप्स वर अंडर प्रेशर, दे वर डाउन एट वन पॉइंट नियरली 2-2.5%, बट क्लोज अगेन विद इन 1%। एंड द जनरल सेंटिमेंट रिमेन्ड अनसर्टन दिस वीक एंड एंडिंग इन दिस वीकेंड विद यू नो अडानी स्टॉक्स स्टिल, मैनी ऑफ देम स्टिल एट दियर लोअर सर्किट्स, मेटल स्टॉक्स टेकिंग अ बीटिंग आफ्टर दी फेड मिनट्स, कमोडिटी स्टॉक्स लाइक शुगर ऑल्सो टेकिंग अ बीटिंग। सो इन जनरल देर वॉज मोर ऑफ प्रॉफिट टेकिंग एंड वीकर हैंड्स शेकन आउट ऑफ द मार्केट। द एंटायर वीक हैज बीन ए रेड वीक। एज यू कैन सी मोस्ट ऑफ द इंडाइसेस हैव एंडेड इन द रेड फॉर द वीक। इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेक्टोरल इंडाइसेस, there was a surprising sell-off in the public sector enterprises. Some energy stocks and PSU banks also were getting hammered. Commodity stocks, as I said, were under pressure. Metal stocks were under pressure, although they did recover a bit towards the end. IT stocks started nicely in the morning, but then they too succumbed to the pressure. FMCG and consumption remained more or less unscathed through the day. So for the week now, metals are down almost 6.5%. That's a pretty sharp cut. And public sector enterprise and PSU banks are also down quite a bit. So it has been a somber week for many of the sectors. In terms of weekend investing, small case performances, ATH was taking a hard knock along with NNF10 this week. Both are down about 7%. In the last 5 days. That's a pretty harsh knockoff, mainly because of exposure to Adani stocks. But even otherwise, other stocks were also capitulating today in both the portfolios. MI All Cap, however, did quite well and closed even. And MI 30 and MI 50 also were not so bad today. Overall, for the week, of course, most strategies, almost all strategies, were in the red. But if we see from a FY perspective, many of them are still with healthy gains at 35% and 27%, so on and so forth. So today's topic is how to overcome fear of investing. Last couple of days have been very eventful with the Fed minutes coming out and profit booking, and this entire week of you know Adani stocks being volatile, some of them, and the others hitting lower circuits every day. So my sense of this overcoming of fear, the first point is that if you are fearful in the market, then you must re-look at why you are there in the market. See, the markets are, especially the investing side, I mean, we are all doing investing here, and I'm not talking about the trading part. These are all medium to long-term strategies or positions that you're taking, right? There will be many, many such speed breakers along the way. 5% dips, 10% dips, they will keep happening. And at each such juncture, if you will take out your money, or will get jittery, your life will become hell. So the idea is to allocate only that much money which you're comfortable with having a hit on. So in equity, as they say, if you're coming to the equity market and you're investing for the long term, please be ready to take a hit of 30, 40, 50% at any point of time. If you are not ready for that, then you must rethink your allocation to the market and reduce it to the extent which makes it comfortable in case you get that hit. Most people have allocated more than what they should allocate to the market, मे बी इन 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 द सेंस ऑफ नॉट हैविंग द नॉलेज टू डू सो और मे बी इन ग्रीड और मे बी यू नो दे आर फर्स्ट डूइंग इट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एंड हेंस देर इज नो एलोकेशन टू एनीथिंग एल्स एंड दैट्स ओके आई मीन इफ यू आर वेरी यंग एंड यू आर एलोकेटिंग मोस्टली टू द मार्केट दैट्स फाइन एंड 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 दैट्स द एज टू बी टेकिंग रिस्क सो सो अनलेस यू विल टेक दोज रिस्क यू विल नॉट लर्न द लेसन द मार्केट नीड्स टू लेट यू लर्न सो देर आर मैनी मैनी सच वेरिएबल्स विच कैन यू नो हेल्प यू reduce your fear. So fear largely will come because of the mismatch of your allocation and your expectation. If you're expecting to make a lot of money in the short term and hence you're allocating a lot of money to the particular investment style, that may or may not happen. So when your expectations get dashed or when you get become fearful on a 5% or a 10% drop, that clearly shows that you know your expectations may be unreal, or maybe you have some recency bias that every month my portfolio has to go up or every year it has to go up. It may not happen that way, right? So my suggestion would be to re-evaluate what you are allocating to the market, what should be the risk on that, how much are you willing to take a hit on that in case things go against you, and so that you may live your life normally while you are investing. The purpose of investing is not to be at the edge of your seat 24/7. The purpose is so that you can beat the inflation, have significant growth in your capital, but also to have a normal life beyond that. One of the key reasons, as I said, is the way you are putting in your capital. So the dollar cost averaging, or in our context we should call it rupee cost averaging, the SIP method basically eliminates that that huge shock if in case you are coming in to the market and it happens to be at the top of the market for that cycle. That can happen, right? Nobody knows how the cycle will play out in the next 1, 2, 3 years. But we know that over 5, 7 years, many cycles may come and go, or at least one cycle will come and go, and you will be able to bear that fruit. At least that is the higher confidence level on that. There is nothing like 100% sure about anything. If somebody invested in Japan in 1989, 1990, they are still waiting. But we are in a growth economy. We are hopeful that there will be these expansion and contraction cycles within the underlying long-term growth that we have in our country. So let's look at how the rupee cost averaging can help you in lowering some risk as well as smoothening out your process of investing and giving you more confidence over time. So you break your investment into pieces. You may do a small starting lump sum and then do a SIP wise allocation, or you may want to do a start and then you say I'll wait for an opportunity for my next opportunistic investment in your stock or a strategy or whatever it may be. This is not in context of small cases only. I'm talking in general here. So you could put them in equity SIPs on equal time intervals, or you can put them ad hoc in terms of opportunistic lump sums. But what the intent is to try and remove the stress and the anxiety of the market moving against you when you have invested a large amount. So let's see how SIPs versus lump sum work in, let's say, volatile scenario. Let's assume a stock which stays near about the same stock in, let's say, 10 months. This is a stock which started at 100, went to 85, 65, then went to 120 and back to 100. So overall, if you did buy and hold lump sum over 10 months, you started with 5 lakhs, you ended with 5 lakhs, you made nothing. But if the same stock, let's say you started with 50,000 rupees first month. You got 500 shares, and then next month the price was 80, and you got, you again put in 50,000, and you got 625 shares. And then month you put in, you know, another 50,000 at 95, you get 526, so on and so forth. So you can see that your amount of stock will keep varying, even though your investment amount remained the same over each time period as the price moves up and down. And if you see this particular calculation here, where your average buy price was 93.5 and you bought, you know, 5,491 shares, you got a ROI of about 10%. Actually, we should have calculated XIRR here for more accuracy, but just for approximation, you can see that if the stock or the index is moving up and down, your gradual entry can phase in your average prices and smoothen out and possibly give you better returns as well on that. Another scenario we could think of is that the stock keeps going down, you know, and or maybe this is an index or maybe this is a portfolio, and you keep investing the same amount each month. Here again, you can see that the number of shares that you're buying per investment keeps going up, right? So in lump sum investing, if you invested 5 lakhs at the beginning and waited till here, you got a 40% drawdown, your ROI is minus 40, and in sipping down, you've reduced it to minus 26%. So your drawdowns are lesser, and when you know the pickup will happen, you will have that entire base to build upon that as you go up. So different scenarios will have different outcomes. The same again in a bull market scenario, where the stock just keeps going up, you know, it's going from 100 to 140. Here what will happen is that lump sums will do better, because you've come in at a lower price, and the stock just keeps going up, and you are gradually entering in the SIP fashion. Here your SIP ROI is less at 17%, and much more in the lump sum at 40%. But overall, if you see, we don't know where we are when we are starting, right? We don't know if it's going to be downhill from here, it's going to be uphill from here, will it remain flat from here. So what happens usually is that when we come in with a lump sum, and with any small blip also, we feel that we will just lose it all, and hence we may panic and we may exit out of it. But when we have a plan that no, we will gradually, you know, keep allocating to it, and I have a 5-year roadmap, and you know, I'll save this much every month from my savings and invest this much, then you are not so much worried about your investment taking a big hit, because you know that, you know, if the underlying strategy or underlying stock or the underlying index is robust, and over time it will, you know, show its growth, then you know that it's a matter of time that I'm getting opportunities of even investing in lower prices with higher quantities. So that is how the you know, the rupee cost averaging can play to your benefit. Now let's see an actual example of MI25, our small case, which deals only in small caps. So we had a drawdown of about 30% in this from the peak of January 18. If you recall, from January 18, small caps had a crash of about 65%, and this strategy had a drawdown of about 30-odd%. So we've taken from peak to peak. So from 1st January 18 till now, which is almost the peak as of now for the small caps, it's about 3.46 years. And we basically, either we did a lump sum of 7,65,000 and bought, and this is as per the index, you know, the index was 318 for MI25 then, and it's 585 now. You would have got a CAGR of about 19%. Even if you came in at the very peak of last small cap rally. So if you were unfortunate enough to bring in a lump sum at January 2018, but were, you know, steadfast enough to hold on for all this while and maybe even add capital. But even if assuming that you did not add capital, you would have still made 19% CAGR as of today. So that is the beauty of you know, having the underlying strategy being robust. If you did the same thing over a SIP, let's say you brought in 1,50,000 at that start, and then you added 15,000 rupees every month or so, then this entire phase you would have added, even when it was at a drawdown of minus 30%, you would have added more units of the portfolio, and at the end of the day you would have got a XIRR of 38%. That much difference would have happened if you brought in you know, the SIPs at a you know, on a regular basis after this. So always have a long term plan, always have a roadmap of how you are going to invest gradually, because lump sum investing can be a winner only if you get lucky that you are coming in and the market goes up from there on and you are able to exit at that point. So but more often than not, most people cannot time. I can also not time the market. I've been in the market for 25 years. I have failed to time the market whenever I've tried to do that. So the idea is to not try to time the market unless you are a, you know, a trading expert. We are trying to do investing here, which should take 2 minutes of our life every week, and that should be about it. We should not be sitting in front of the screen the entire day and, you know, having our heartbeat go to 120 and 140 for no reason whatsoever. If your time zone is 3 years, 5 years, why are you worried about 3 hours and 5 hours to start with? So I'll end the today's bite by these you know, points that you should be thinking about. You should educate yourself about what you're doing, what you're investing in, what is your roadmap, you know, how you're going to play the long-term game here. What happens if the market gives you opportunities? How will you invest in those opportunities? Will you be able to draw in more capital from elsewhere? Always start small, because when we are starting with less experience normally, and we are starting with, you know, baby steps, and once we start to walk, only then we can run. So don't try to, you know, do a marathon if you've been sitting on the sofa for last 5 years. So we need to gradually train ourselves, train our mind, train our system, and then gradually you will be able to build it up. There should not be any hurry. Understand what you're doing. You know, if you're investing in particular stocks, particular sectors, particular strategies, please understand how they behave. In what kind of market will you be gaining, in what kind of market will those not be working, so on and so forth. And always have a, you know, risk management in place, that if in case this strategy does not work, I am not exposed to it, you know, 100% of my capital. Nothing is 100% in this world. So you need to diversify, you need to have, you know, your eggs in different baskets, you need to have backup plans, so on and so forth. But most important is be consistent. Whatever plan you've made, please be consistent. Don't look at the TV every day or hear your friend every day and say, okay, let me just change my entire plan, what I had drawn for the next 10 years and start doing this from today. And then tomorrow again, you know, somebody tells you something, so I'll scrap everything that I've been doing and I'll start doing that. That is a sure shot recipe for disaster. So think about all this, go over all these points, create your plans, create your risk management, create your investing, you know, how you are going to invest and save and gradually invest. And over time, you will do well. I'm assuring you that you will do well if you will follow all these things that we talked about today. So have a great weekend, although the last week was not so good, but forget about markets for now. Have a great 2 days and try to think about this and formulate a plan which can help you in the future. So thank you and goodbye.